On the occasion of World Hypertension Week, we have Dr. Jaya Kumar with us.
Hello everybody, this is Dr. Jaya Kumar, Consultant Intervention Pathology at Apollo BJS Hospital, Mysore.
Doctor, why is hypertension called silent killer and what complications can occur if hypertension is not treated?
Unlike any other disease, hypertension is usually we call it as silent killer because usually it doesn't produce symptoms as such unless the patient lands up in some complication related to hypertension, because unlike the diabetes, unlike fever, unlike other diseases where some symptoms patient can recognize and go and get treated himself, hypertension usually doesn't cause major symptom as such. Very rarely it may cause headache or giddiness or fatigability. That is very rare. That's why unless the end organ damage is noticed, hypertension doesn't cause any symptoms, so it is called a silent killer. For example, as you ask, what are the complications related to it? For example, we know that vessels are there from head to toe. If hypertension is not controlled or not treated adequately, it can affect any organ from head to toe. For example, if it affects the brain, the patient can develop stroke or bleeding manifestation. If it can affect the eyes, it can cause retinal complications. If it affects the heart, it can cause major heart attack or heart failure symptoms. Or if usually the next commonest thing what we notice in hypertension is the kidney failure. You might have heard many patients landing up in end-stage kidney disease which requires long-term dialysis and other medication which should be taken for lifelong. So these are some of the complications if hypertension is not treated adequately.
Doctor, what dietary changes should be made to reduce heart disease risk?
See, reducing the excessive salt intake and consuming a lot of fruits, fresh fruits and vegetables, and especially in hypertension, any patient with hypertension or diabetes is the commonest risk factor for heart disease. These should be well under control. Not only identification of disease is important, and also the disease should be well under control with adequate medication, with regular monitoring which requires, and regular lifestyle modification should be done. As I told, one is the reduced intake. If the patient is already a smoker, you should quit smoking. Alcoholics can and should reduce the alcohol consumption. Consumption of whole fruits and vegetables, keeping physical fitness, going for a walk at least 30 to 45 minutes per day, maintaining adequate body weight, keeping and maintaining the blood cholesterol level. These are some of the important factors which will going to help you to maintain or control the risk of heart disease. And nowadays, especially the most important thing, why the youngsters are more susceptible to is because of stress. Stress might be in any form, personal stress, or financial stress, or professional stress. Stress is becoming more and more pandemic worldwide, where the young populations are succumbing to this hypertension and related complications of heart disease. I think one should learn to de-stress themselves and lead a simple and happy life, stress-free life.
Causes excessive cholesterol in the blood. What are the complications if cholesterol level is high?
Well, we have two types of cholesterol. In general, the HDL cholesterol, which is a good cholesterol, and LDL cholesterol, which is a bad cholesterol. What are the concerns with the bad cholesterol is, as the blood level of cholesterol goes on increases, it is going to cause accumulation in the body, accumulation in the blood vessels, thereby causing narrowing of the blood vessels. As the narrowing of the blood vessels increases, the organ supplied by it will going to suffer because of decreased blood supply, decreased oxygen and decreased nutrients. So this cholesterol can be reduced only by having a healthy lifestyle. What I meant by healthy lifestyle is, this bad cholesterol is because of excessive consumption of calories, refined food, smoking and unhealthy lifestyle, and lack of physical activity. Similarly, lack of physical activity or sedentary life itself is a major risk factor for any population, which can lead to increased cholesterol as well as increase the risk of heart disease. So leading a healthy lifestyle by reducing the consumption of refined food, consuming more fruits and vegetables, keeping physical activity, avoid sedentary lifestyle, can help in the long term in achieving the goals of normal cholesterol.
So is it important to regularly get checkup of lipid levels? How often should it be done? And what are the medications given for high cholesterol?
I think everyone, irrespective of male or female, irrespective of family history or work background, at least one they should have the baseline cholesterol level at the age of 35 to 40 years. In between 35 to 40 years, at least once their cholesterol should be done. If the patient is having more risk factors, like example, someone is having the family history of ischemic heart disease, family history of high cholesterol, if the person is obese, if the person is smoker, alcoholic, or person is already a diabetic, hypertension, Okay, these type of patients will be requiring a yearly cholesterol checkup. Other patients with baseline normal cholesterol can have their lipid profile repeat checkup after maybe 2 to 3 years. Basically, it depends on the baseline cholesterol level and the risk factor that person carries. Other than healthy lifestyle, we have few medications depending on the type of cholesterol the patient has and the risk factors he carries. We can give medications to reduce the cholesterol, thereby reducing the complications related to high cholesterol.
So, in the present scenario of COVID-19, how can a patient take care of his heart? Also, for normal people, what precautions and measures they should take to maintain a healthy heart?
I think the standard precaution for avoiding COVID-19 is social distancing, hand washing, and the use of proper mask. I think these three go in a long way in preventing the spread of the infection and acquiring the infection. In compared to in persons with heart disease or a patient with hypertension, I think the same standard care which a heart patient requires holds good for even in COVID-19 situation. But during this season, please try to avoid unnecessary travel, try to avoid unnecessary exposure in the public places, always wear a mask, always use sanitizer whenever you are entering the house, and try to avoid going for public places. And maintaining a social distance at the public places is more important. And third one is the wearing the mask. Whenever you are going outside the house, please wear a mask. I think these three basic concepts will go into helping a long way to prevent the spread of COVID infection as well as prevent its complications.